Okay, so maybe Hurricane Matthew is messing up your weekend plans, but what if you had your wedding planned for this weekend?
Can you imagine if you were supposed to get married this weekend? Well, let me tell you, there's one couple, they had wedding plans, and now they're trying to come up with something else to do. Our Stephen Dial is live with that. Stephen.
Hey, guys, you know the superstition. If it rains a little on your wedding, it's good luck. Well, for this couple you're about to meet, I think rain is the least of their worries.
I didn't think about hurricane season. I thought of football season and people being like, no, we don't want to travel because of the game.
Every girl dreams about her wedding day, and there's a lot of planning that goes into it.
Centerpieces that I've been working on for months and months, and flower girl basket, and oh, that's my emergency kit down there. So I thought I was super prepared.
For Katie Grace, her wedding, to say the least, will be very unique. Her fiance Scott popped the question in January. Their wedding date is this Saturday, all while Northeast Florida is expecting a possible historic weather event.
She planned everything from day one. It was kind of insert groom here because she was that organized, which was pretty impressive. So for all of that to kind of take a turn and try to almost replan a wedding within just a couple day period, it's been fun.
So far, the couple is on standby for the wedding venue. The reception area says they can possibly use a backup generator. Right now, Katie and Scott have a backup plan for the backup plan.
It's been everything from we have a family member that potentially is ordained and could do the ceremony, and we just kind of do it wherever we can. I think her qualification is if she can have running water to take a shower and get ready to put the dress on, we're going to try to make this happen, assuming we get the right family members here. And
we will have stories for forever, whether this ends up being our wedding day or whether we have our invitation that says one date and then a wedding that actually happens on a different date. So
the wedding may be up in the air, but one thing is certain, the name of their child.
That's not happening. That name will be officially crossed off the list.
Retired.
Now.
Yeah. The name is retired.
Unfortunately, he has a brother, Matt, too. So,
who took the red eye in to get here.
Yes. So there's at least some good Matt in this situation. So.
And that's what we're all hoping for, for Hurricane Matthew not to be that devastating to this area. I know it made a slight turn east, but everyone needs to take everything serious. And that couple, they're just crossing their fingers. As for the groom, before I send it back to you guys, as for the groom, he says the day that he proposed, it was stormy, it was raining. And then when they got on the beach, everything cleared up. So hopefully everything will clear up for them on Saturday. Back to you guys.
I know you so well. I can't tell by the sound of your voice if you're really in love with me. And you are, and you are. You know I can't lie. If I say to you, baby, I love you, then baby, I love you. Oh, and I do. Yes, I do. I do. Could it be that's a phrase you thought never would phase you? Well, baby, you better hold on tight. 'Cause I'm the one who's supposed to kneel down and propose. Well, all right. Ooh, I might. So when I kiss you goodnight, just sleep tight with the thought that you'll always be caught up in love with me. And you'll dream and the stars up above have the answer of whether we'll be or whether we won't be in love. Well, we are. Yes, we are.
Hey, Someday, when I'm awfully low, when the world is cold, I will feel a glow just thinking of you. And the way you look tonight, yes, you're lovely with your smile so warm and your cheeks so soft. There is nothing for me but to love you and the way you look tonight. With each word, your tenderness grows, tearing my fear apart. And that laugh that wrinkles your nose, it touches my foolish heart. Lovely, don't you ever change. Keep that breathless charm. Won't you please arrange it? 'Cause I love you just the way you look tonight. Just the way you look tonight.
And we're going to continue to take a look at some of the damage around our area a little later, but I love this next story.
Yes.
It's a great follow-up story. We told you about this couple. They were planning on getting married this weekend, but they were a little concerned because of Hurricane Matthew.
Okay, this story's going to make you smile. You got to see how in just 48 hours, they managed to pull off a wedding. Here's Stephen Nile.
Hurricane Matthew left downed trees and power lines, and the couple that we introduced to you Thursday thought it would ruin their wedding. But with some last-minute help and some new friends, the wedding went on as planned.
Yeah, not my church wedding and all the details. So I think the only thing that stayed was maybe decorations and dress, and everything else was different.
Katie and Scott got engaged in January, their wedding date, October 8th. The problem they didn't see 9 months earlier, it would be on the same weekend a hurricane would sweep across Northeast Florida.
I think we were defeated. It was
defeated was the word.
We threw the towel in, we said, you know, it's not gonna work.
Days before Hurricane Matthew made its way here, the couple had to do a lot of last-minute adjustments, like getting a new venue.
Actually, they reached out to us last night via Facebook. I got his phone number, called him up. I said, hey, let's make this happen.
A new venue means a new caterer.
And I got this call around 10:30 today, and I said, you know, why not? It's for love. And you know what Carrabba's does for the community? We were there anyways. I had to do it.
Luckily, they didn't have to find a new DJ. They just had to make sure the storm damage wouldn't stop him from coming.
Actually, I got a text message yesterday during the hurricane that to see if I was still available and that I was still in town.
So what seemed like a doomed wedding a few days ago.
By the power vested in me, I now pronounce you man and wife. You may kiss your bride.
Became by far the most memorable weekend with friends new and old.
So many people stepped in and I mean, the thank you cards that we're gonna have to write for this.
Oh, yeah.
I'll be honest, I think originally that was something that I thought, oh, that's something Katie's gonna do. I think my hand is gonna hurt after all the thank you letters we have to write.
And if you were wondering, I asked the couple what would they name their first child. They say Matthew is the first name that's not gonna be on the list. On the south side, Stephen Dial, First Coast News.
Oh, man. Oh, what a story, Stephen. Congratulations.
Story.
That did make us smile. We wish them the best
of
luck.
Yes,
pulling it off just like that. Way to go.